Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to this afternoon's organ recital. If I haven't met you yet, my name's Thomas Dilley. I've just started here as organ scholar, and it's a great pleasure to welcome Andrew Caskie today for our recital. He's, as you can see on the program, he's managing director of Nicholson Organ Builders and is also an organist at Great Malvern Priory, having been organist and director of music at Palmerston Place Church in Edinburgh for over 12 years. And to introduce his program, please give a warm welcome to Andrew Caskie.
Thank you very much. It's a great pleasure and privilege to be here. I'm very grateful to Andrew for the kind invitation, and thanks in advance to Tom for his page turning. Just a quick word about the program today. We start with a piece by Johann Roman, who was a composer to the Swedish royal court in the 17th century. If you didn't know this piece, you might think it was written by Handel. And it's not a coincidence, Roman was often referred to as the Swedish Handel. And it's a lovely overture that really sets the scene. This has been arranged for the organ by a Stockholm organist, Patrick Vretblad. Then something completely different, we go to Alec Rowley's Benedictus. Alec Rowley was a London-based organist, composer and teacher. He composed a great deal for music students to play, you know, a set piece for a sight reading, for grade five, that kind of thing. And a great swathes of his output was for that kind of use. But he did write quite a lot of organ music, much of which has sadly been forgotten. But some of his pieces are enjoying a bit of a renaissance, among which is this lovely Benedictus, composed in 1931. And it's a very quiet piece, a bit like one of Howell's Psalm Preludes. It starts quiet, builds up, and then dies away again. And this is inspired by two lines from a poem by Christina Rossetti: I bring you rest and ease, I bring you contentment. The third piece is a more modern piece by Cecilia McDowall, who has written a good deal for the choir, for choirs to sing and for organists. And this piece, Church Bells Beyond the Stars, is the third of a trilogy of pieces that she has written for the organ, all inspired by various lines from poems by George Herbert. This third piece was commissioned by the Edinburgh Society of Organists in 2013 to commemorate that association's centenary. And I had a small part in the decision to do that. And it's lovely to be able to distribute and play this piece more often. It really is a depiction of the randomness of ringing bells, and then there's a lovely, mysterious, quieter section in the middle. We then finish with a great warhorse of the French Romantic repertoire. Alexandre was organist of La Trinité in Paris for many years, and a prolific composer, performer, and teacher. Among his works are eight organ sonatas. A bit like the sonatas of Mendelssohn, these are really suites of contrasting movements, and there's not a great deal of musical thread that links each movement. It's just a suite of pieces that kind of hang together stylistically. In comparison to his contemporary César Franck, Guilmantv's music is very secular. It's not dripping with incense in the way that César Franck's often is. And this is very robust and rhythmic and very much inspired for recital use. This fifth sonata dates from 1894, and I do hope that you enjoy hearing that. Thank you for coming. I do hope that you enjoy the music. And I'll start with the Sinfonia di Chiesa by Johann Roman.